You may have a seat. I want to demonstrate something to you. Praise God. How many feel an anointing in the room? Amen. This is God's government. This is a scroll that's 312 years old. Found in Auschwitz and Birkenau. It's a Holocaust scroll. Because the Jews, we love the government of God. We took it with us under our clothes, Auschwitz and Birkenau. And what God did, ladies and gentlemen, is this. They threw them outside the tracks of Auschwitz and Birkenau. That's where these are. I collect scrolls. These are priceless. A brand new scroll starts at $60,000. These, you can't get insurance for. Because there's no more. In other words, this scroll was resurrected from the dead. It was brought back to life. Many of you still have the dust of Auschwitz and Birkenau on them. And so now I'm going to uncover this. 12 years old, and I'm going to pull off the foreskin of this. We're going to raise it up. And this is called the belt of righteousness. And when Jesus walked into the temple, he wasn't walking into a religious earthly court system. He was walking into a government. He was walking as a judge. He walked up to the bema. He untied the seat of righteousness. He took the belt of righteousness. He laid it on the bema. He opened up the scroll. There are 39 lambskins. By 39 stripes you're healed. Stop. Every column is called leaves. And according to the book of Revelation, the leaves were for the healing of the nations. We as Jews, we come there, we don't even touch it with our hand, we touch it with a finger, the authority of God, only given to one of great authority. 90% of Jews in the world have never even seen, came close, nor touched a scroll, because these are kept in arks behind eternal lights, Talmids. This is called the seams. Every one of us was a lamb that had to die, like Jesus did. It takes 3.5 years to write a scroll by a shofar. Jesus started his ministry at age 30. He died at age 33.5. It takes 3.5 years to write one. Jesus called himself the Devar Elohim, the Word of God incarnate. He called himself the internal government of God. And these are only given to cities that need to be released into a new anointing. I have dual citizenship in Israel on behalf of the Jewish people, the land of Israel, and the God of Israel. I want to make a presentation. Praise God. Amen. Bishop, you will come. Bishop, you will come. Praise God. Praise God. He is a king. God's blessed him. He's a humble man. But in him is kingship. In him his royalty. In him was the land of Israel. In him was a K chromosome of that of Kohen and Kohanim. He was brought through the slaves, raised up in a city, and God now wants to release a new anointing. We're in a different season, ladies and gentlemen. You'll come, Bishop. Thank you so much, sir. Bishop, you'll turn and face this. He now looks as one who was once a slave, and his ancestors were once slaves. He's the first man in 3,500 years of his bloodline to return back to the original, seeing the original scroll, seeing the original letters. There are 22 letters on a Hebrew alphabet. There are 22 pairs of chromosomes in your body. The 23rd was added by man. There are 22 amino acids. On Psalms 22, it was written at Calvary. Jewish doctors say when you look in a microscope, your cells of your body look exactly like script Hebrew letters. There are crowns, because this is God's government. Matthew 5, 17 through 19, Yeshua said, "Do not think that I come to do away with my government, my Torah, but to bring it to a greater understanding. For those who teach the Torah, as he will be released to, would consider great in Malchut Shemayim, great in the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, my country on the earth. For those who speak against him, will be considered least in the kingdom of God, least in the kingdom of earth." Ladies and gentlemen, if you turn, Bishop, towards me, and we're going to now surround him. This is done in the kings of Israel. They surround him, raise it in the air. He now wrap him in the scroll real slow, real slow.
Listen.
He's wrapped in the Word of God. He's sealed by the blood of the Messiah. He is sealed to come out with a new anointing. The kingship within him, the power within him is going to come out. It doesn't matter where you go. Now, how you try to attack him, you can't attack him. He's sealed. Wherever he works, wherever he turns, the power of God is there. As we open this up, every ambassador, every king, this is done to every king. We open up and he's hidden in the Word of God. He is hidden in the Word of God. Amen. These are called trees, Eitz Chaim. He sits between two courtrooms, justice and blessing. I speak life over you. I speak life as a Jew. I speak life over you in the name of Yeshua. Roll it up. I want to show you something. Roll it up. Put the cover on it. Praise God. This will either arouse the realm of death in you, or it'll arouse the realm of life. You have a choice. Now, Bishop, you'll have a seat. Praise God. He's now positioned in a seat of a position of power and authority. He has given within him a belt. On one side is justice, and the other is blessing. He now is given the constitution of God as a king. I give this to you, Bishop, as a sign of covenant, as a sign of release, as my sign of love for you. Amen. My brothers will come forth, four sons representing the four corners of the earth. They'll raise him up right now. He now is raised up from a commoner to a kingship. Come on, raise it up. And I'll walk him around. Come on! Come on, praise God. Turn to face here. Turn to face me. Hold it in the air. He's no longer a commoner. He's not on the earth. He's raised from earth into a heavenly realm. He's raised in a prophetic position. He's released by God. He's breaking pagan traditions, breaking areas of God. He's releasing Atlanta, Georgia. It's not him. It's the king in him. Say this with me. Nicole, come here. Nicole. Now walk with me. We're going to sing the Aaronic blessing found in the book of Numbers. Let's sing it together, Nicole.
Yivarechecha Adonai ve'yishmarecha Ya'er Adonai panavalecha ve'yichunecha Yivarecha Adonai panavalecha ve'yasemlecha
Stretch forth your hand, stretch forth your hand. Say, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift you up and give you a special anointing. And from the Prince of Peace, Yeshua HaMashiach, we love you, Bishop. We raise you up. We raise you up for such a time as this. God has made a prophet out of you, and we release the anointing in Yeshua's name. Amen? Let's sing the song. Sing the song. Are you ready to prepare the way? Sing it. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Yeshua. Praise God. Begin to pray in spirit. Come on, everybody sing it. Let's go. You can bring it down. Praise God. Let's sing. sing it. Come on.
Yeshua.
Yeshua. Church of New Birth for such a time as this. There is a new birth. Say a new birth. A new beginning. Praise God. How many just love God? How many love God? I'm serious. How many are fire for God? Praise God. Amen. Everything that we did today and everything is in this book. We'll have Torah, Law, Grace. I'm going to turn it back over to the bishop. Thank you for the honor on behalf of the Jewish people, the land of Israel, and the God of people. God of Israel, I want to thank you. God bless you. Praise you. Come on, come on, and bless the Lord.